The following presentation is brought to you by Trumbull Photo, Film, and Commercials, the best source for high-quality photography, videography, and video marketing. For more information on how we can serve you, please reach out to Levi Trumbull with the contact information seen on the screen in front of you, or visit us on the web at trumbullphotofilm.com. We'd love to hear from you. Thank you and enjoy.
NBC Studios.
Oh, you're here.
NBC Studios is the home of such great shows that are no longer on the air, like Cheers, Friends, Seinfeld.
Those are some great shows. People watch them.
Yes, they did.
So the situation here at NBC is a little bit different.
Help us, please! Help us. Sorry, ignore my begging. We're offering a contest.
Yes, an amazing contest. We're asking you, the common people.
The unwashed, the people who sleep till noon, the ones who wear pajamas all day and have an 80% frozen pizza diet.
Yes, you people. Come up with NBCs.
The ones who shop late at night at Walmart, the ones who eat Taco Bell.
Sammy.
Sorry.
Anyway, come up with NBC's newest show. Pitch us your ideas and we will make that show.
Seriously, we are completely out of ideas.
Completely. We're all out. The tank is empty. We're considering doing all singing competitions from now on.
Singing, the dancing star.
American Idol meets The Voice meets Dancing with the Stars meets So You Think You Can Dance meets Twerkin' It.
Twerkin' It is my personal favorite. I just love that show. It's so well-rounded.
And since my idea got shot down.
No one wants to see Man vs. Donkey.
It's a reality show about who man finds a donkey. Simple, elegant, awesome.
Woolly. Man vs. Donkey isn't gonna happen.
I'm feeling creatively neutered here.
Get over it!
Never! Alright, I'm over it. I've learned to swallow my feelings here at NBC. Helps keep me going.
So? Help us, please, save NBC! This is all we know! Was that too desperate?
Is this thing on?
You are right in front of us.
Anytime you're ready.
Pitch away.
It's called, here, get this, Veterinarians.
Okay.
No, that's it. Here, look. Veterinarians.
That's your idea?
Yep. It's got veterinarians in it. It's pretty awesome. Just veterinarians.
So are there animals in the show too,
well,
or?
No. You see, it's about veterinarians. How many times do I have to say that? Veterinarians.
I'm just trying to figure out your
answer. It's got veterinarians, all right, man. People who are veterinarians.
Can we see a clip?
What is wrong with you?
Let's see if we film something.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You see, I have anger issues with people who don't see how great of a person I am.
I totally identify. I'm in a rage all the time around here.
I didn't know that.
Bottled up.
Well, here's my clip.
No! You're too beautiful to die! No! No!
good show.
Actually,
shut up, you're ruining it.
Typical.
What?
I like you, Laura, but you're a loose cannon. You don't play by the rules of veterinarians.
I don't need to play by the rules. I'm twice the veterinarian you'll ever be.
You take that back.
Never.
I can't stand the fighting.
Look what you did to Tom.
He was like that before.
No time for personal conflicts. We've got him coming.
We saved her. High fives, everyone.
You know, I don't like you, but I sure as hell respect you.
Same here.
Yeah.
We'll call you.
An ordinary day. A man, perhaps any man, is walking along the street. An ordinary street. Could be anywhere. And then, wait for it.
And today's such a beautiful day for walking around.
Oh! CJ, it's night. A different man is playing with his son, teaching him baseball. Teaching him how to swing the bat, and then...
All right, bud. So you hold the bat up like this, okay? And then you make sure to keep your eye on the pitcher. Because if you do, then you can see where the ball is, right?
Ah! That's awesome!
Wait a minute. Is this all the show is?
Yep.
We'll call you.
Wait. I think she's got
we'll
some.
We'll call you.
You can do this, Jessica. You can do this. You're smart. You look nice and green. Most people like you.
Breathe.
We're actually over here.
Do you mind?
Sorry?
And stretch, 2, 3.
Ooh. Greetings, NBC executive.
Who is this girl in front of me, and why is she so magnetic?
The answer is simple. Pizzazz. I've got it, and now I'm going to give it to you. What does your show line up need?
Oh, no. Not another situational comedy. We've already had them.
Yes, but you didn't have this situational comedy. Compelling characters?
Check.
Hilarious one-liners?
Check.
Breakout stars? Double check. What is this show and where can I get it?
That's when you say, what is this show and where can I get it?
You just said that.
I know. I was helping you with your line.
You need to say that. I'm not gonna say it.
Well, you're going to look pretty stupid when I wait up here for 4 hours waiting for my cue.
What is this show and where can I get it?
I'm so glad you asked. And now that I've piqued your curiosity, it's time
for Star Trek!
Exclamation point. What happens when a famous existential philosopher moves in with an ordinary wacky family in Toledo? Hilarity. And a little heartwarming fun.
And also the contemplation of the essential meaningless of existence.
I am the void. These pretty things, these skeletons, the birds, they are hollow. Anything that flies, or alights, or treads upon the world is empty inside. A shell of feathers and froth concealing the nightmare beneath.
Hi, Jean-Paul. How's it going?
Do not ask questions as you do not seek the answer for.
You're so funny. Well, guess what I did today?
Hid your fear of death behind a veil of makeup?
No, I didn't do that. I signed someone up for OKCupid. Guess who I signed up for OKCupid?
No.
Yes.
No.
Please guess.
I am not your monkey. certain of nothing. My desires are phantoms. I am instinct and rationalization.
I'm not sure what that means.
It means that I am not your monkey.
You!
I have forgotten what this conversation is about.
I signed you up for OKCupid. And here she is now.
That's him?
Yep. Jean-Paul Sartre, meet El Carnazzi.
Sartre.
What?
My name is pronounced Sartre.
Oh! I didn't know that. He's French.
Sweet.
So I'll just get out of your hair. I'm so happy.
So, what do you do?
Well, I am a man.
Uh-huh. So you got a job?
I do have a profession.
You're a professor.
No.
Okay, so I was on my way here, and this guy drives by me, and he's like, "Hey, you got a nice figure!" Except, he didn't say figure. I'm not gonna say what he says, because I'm like a lady, right? So, anyway, I yell, "Why don't you drive on the cliff, you scum-sucking piece of trash?" You know, real ladylike and all, because I got standards. I'm the mirror. So, anyway, he puts his car in reverse and starts backing up, middle of traffic. And I'm like, "Hey, moron, this ain't making you more attractive." And he's like, "What's your problem? You don't like people? I don't like you. You don't know me. You know what your problem is? I don't need you to tell me what my problem is. You got a closed heart. You're not open to love. Go home and die!" Next thing you know, he gets out of his car and starts crossing three lanes of traffic. And he's like, "I don't even know you, and I'm willing to risk my life to get your number. I'm not giving you my number. Give me your number." No! Bam! Semi-truck hits him.
But what did you do?
Oh, I got on the bus. What do you think of that?
Well, I like you.
You. Are you ready?
I was born ready. Actually, I was born screaming, so that
I'm so glad you mentioned babies. This next challenge is called the nursery. You'll be singing your song and catching these babies at the same time. Just like in a real nursery.
There's flying babies in a nursery?
In the exciting ones. What are you going to be singing?
Let's get physical.
Let's get physical? I hate that song. Seriously, you've already lost. I'm kidding. I only mildly dislike that song. Off you go.
Let's get physical, physical. I want to get physical.
All right, stop. Let's hear what our beloved Moldy Judge has to say.
I really don't know how to put this, but I loved every minute of it. There was a desperation in her voice that was just really, really fun. Oh,
awesome. And now, on to round two. A round I like to call singing inside of a glass box filled with tarantulas. Who wants to go first?
It seems a little derivative to me.
Totally unoriginal. I think it's got a chance.
Well, Paul.
Stopping action. Thrill at the amazing police procedural that goes to places no other police procedural has gone before.
How about you tell me about it, punk?
I'll never talk. I want my lawyer. Now,
scum like you doesn't get lawyers. Scum like you gets a small fine. We take our jaywalking very seriously. Maybe in Walkersville, they let you walk wherever you want. Clearly marked crosswalks, but here, in Imesville, that will give you a $15 fine and a stern talking to.
You'll never break me.
I don't think I need to. Let me introduce you to my partner.
Hi, Ella.
This punk thinks she's too good for clearly marked crosswalks. You make me sick. You make me sick.
Okie dokie, then. How about some coffee?
Never.
I'll have some then. Marcy?
I'm not in the mood to get you coffee. Bob, my stomach is too upset. Because I'm sick. Sick of jaywalking.
Can I have a cup then?
You think this is a joke, do ya? What if there was some kid watching you, looking up to you like a role model? What if he said, will that girl cross the street? What if I cross the street? What if everyone crosses the street whenever they want? Chaos in the streets. All of society breaks down. And cars take a little longer to get through because they have to pause. They have to pause. You just think about that.
Listen, kid, I know you had it tough. Probably had an absent father.
No, actually.
Hold on, I'm trying to relate to you here. It's not easy growing up on the mean streets of Iams without a father figure. But there are programs for people like you. Programs designed to help you.
This punk doesn't deserve help. She deserves help. $15. Fine.
I'm not giving up on this gal just yet.
I am.
I'm not. I'm reaching out my hand for you, gal. Are you gonna take it? Are ya? Are ya?
All the drama, none of the danger.
What happened here?
Well, as far as I can tell, this cow has been tipped over.
He struck again?
Yeah.
This is sick. Sick.
Just tip Bessie right over. She fell down on the ground.
No, Bessie, I love you.
She's still alive, just mildly annoyed.
Me!
Oh.
And then the romantic tension you've all been waiting for.
Yup. 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 Yep. Yup. Yep. I thought you'd never ask.
Garbage men. You've seen Hell's Bathroom. But now it's time for the most dangerous, most dramatic reality TV show of them all, The Writer's Room. Look at them. Look at them. Who will come out on top? Who? Who will get blocked? Ah! Aw! Head cramp! When I saw Jenny cramp up, chance. I mean, she's a good writer and all, but she's weak. She's mentally weak, you know? She's got a brain like a cardboard box. I just pressed on. You know, I had my vision, and as long as I stuck to it, that $100,000 was as good as mine!
You don't even tell them there's no $100,000.
You're not making for compelling viewing.
Get off my lawn!
I want to see more conflict with Sheila.
You're gonna see more conflict with me in a second!
All right. I'm leaving. You guys don't want to be famous.
Okay, well...
Hold on, it gets so much better. I had cameras all over the house.
I'm just not sure NBC is comfortable violating the law like that.
Depends on who's been watching or not.
It's because his mother was overprotective. That's why.
Yeah.
why he's never had a girlfriend. He's emotionally stunted.
What if this part out too? Don't worry.
I want him to get help, you know?
He'll get the help he needs in prison.
That's probably the best place for him. Locked up.
In a dungeon. Wait. Do they still have dungeons?
No, I don't think they still have dungeons anymore, honey.
Why are we even paying taxes if there are no dungeons?
I don't know, but I'm sure it wasn't electro shock therapy or something. They can...
Joey! Just admit that you stole my lawnmower.
I didn't steal your lawnmower.
Admit it.
No!
All right, fine. Can you just try to act like Honey Boo Boo? Just try it.
Go away!
It's easy. All you gotta do is be like, Honey Boo Boo eats all the zingers she wants. It's cause I wanna be sexy.
Joey! Get out!
We'll call you. Seriously, I got like
525,600 hours of footage. I think we'll have to pass on that.
Dang it.
Prepare yourselves for the most heartwarming show you've ever seen. Can you come here for a second? I just saw your report card. Whatever. Wait till your father gets home.
My father, the panda.
Honey, did you see what your daughter got in English? Honey? Honey, are you listening to me? Do you still love me?
show like this in development. My father, the tortoise.
It's more meditative, but they cater to old people, so they figured the tortoise was a good animal the elderly could identify with.
Brilliant idea, though.
Brilliant. We'll call you.
Imagine a show on every night of the week. Every night.
Even Saturday?
Most of Saturday.
Whoa!
It's a reality show where people go out into the community and in fact all over the world and find out things.
Whoa!
Like, let's say there's a fire in town. Someone goes to the fire and films it.
No way!
And then talks about it. Like in a confessional.
What do you call it?
Call it the news.
We've got word from Wall Street today that the interest rate on the 10-year T-note picked up to 2.75%.
Thank you, Gail. I'm sure that we'll be very enthralling to our viewers at home. And now in state news, a new interstate project will cause some delays on your way to work.
So make sure to leave early.
I mean, if you have a job or somewhere to go?
Thanks for that, Chuck.
No problem, Gail. And might I add, you're very attractive today.
Let's keep our urges sublimated, okay, Chuck?
No problem. Under the surface. Like a fault line.
That's where they belong. Deep underground.
That's where I shall put them, then.
And now, let's turn to Jim Smiley for the weather.
What could make news any more awesome, if you might ask? I won't just tell you. I'll show you. Well, it looks like another hot one tomorrow, folks. But the Murphy should!
That's right, it's news wrapped. Watch newscasters attempt to read the news while...
Without some donations, the orphanage will soon be forced to close its doors. Please, if you have anything, you can send it to the
group. Oh! Get light! This just in from the emergency management system. A tornado warning. Oh, my tenders! Yeah!
I was just wondering, is there any way we can make it more difficult for the newscasters?
What if we put them in glass boxes filled with spiders?
What?
Or they had to read the news while inside a tiger's mouth.
Wouldn't the tiger just eat them?
Depends on how good a newscaster they are. I mean, if the story's interesting enough, the tiger will stop chewing and listen.
Yeah, that sounds plausible.
Sounds good to me. Can we bring in the tiger?
Yeah,
you was first!
I'll call you!
You know what your problem is? You know what your problem is? Are you talking to me? Both of you, and the whole network, and humanity. And you expect us to be these perfect little angels, right? Well, we're not. And that's what my new show is about. Unpleasant single women without jobs. I also happen to star in it. You don't even know, Mom. You don't even know. When you were growing up, people just handed you a job right when you got out of college.
Well, I don't know if they handed
you. Do you listen to yourself? Do you realize what the patriarchy is making you say? I reject the entire system. I'm outside of the system.
Oh.
I'm not finding myself, okay? Gen X people found themselves and they should stay lost. Have you seen some of those people? No. What am I doing? If I'm writing my own story outside the letters, words, and punctuation marks.
I don't even know what that means.
Of course you don't. I wouldn't expect that you would. But you know what? It's groundbreaking! I can stay on your insurance, right?
Yeah.
Cool. I'm doing this art installation. I go through a Kickstarter, but it's totally owned by the patriarchy these days. So
what?
So I'm gonna need some investors in my own art.
Isn't your art project your apartment?
Yes, and I need some investors. I'm doing this cool thing where I live like a normal person, while at the same time being radical in my thoughts. How's about 1,200 marks?
Okay, I'll write you a check.
A series of checks would be awesome. Did somebody say love life? I think they did.
Undefined.
Oh, so are we seeing other people, or like...
I see people all the time.
I find that attractive, girls who run into things.
Me too, but it has to be a surprise, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Would you like it if I bumped into something for you?
No, not really.
Okay.
Okay, look, I don't find you attractive.
I don't find you attractive either.
Oh, well, I can't form emotional attachments right now because I am an emotionally stunted narcissist. Yep.
But that's what I like about you.
I guess you could run into something now.
Okay.
Yeah, it didn't really work.
This show is called Don't Date My Mom.
I don't know if...
It's called Don't Date My Mom.
It sounds really fresh.
Nobody better be getting fresh.
I meant the concept sounds fresh.
There's nothing fresh going on here.
Can you see a club?
Why?
See what the show is like?
Alright, but don't get any ideas. Okay, Mom, you only have one notice left to give out. There are only two bachelors left after I kick the other ones off the show. They will now give their final pitch.
Mildred, the time we've spent together has been very magical.
What are you talking about?
That night on the canoe, that is magic. I think I can be the man for you. I can take care of you. I can be there for you. And also check out the...
Whoa! Okay, no.
I know we just met. But when I kissed you...
What? What is wrong with you?
Why, because he seems like a very nice man.
No way. No way. Out. You will not be my mom. Let's hear from contestant number two.
What's up, bruh?
Alright, Brad, it's your last chance to earn that rose.
I'm looking at you right now, baby.
He's not your baby. She's not your baby. I'm your baby.
You look so smoking hot right now, babe.
Ordered bikes, my mother enjoys quiet nights watching TV on the couch, so if you could tell your sweets to that or possibly crocheting, it'd be great.
Don't listen to him. I like to party.
Then I'm your guy. Cause partying is all I do.
I like the sound of that.
No.
How do you feel about dance hooks?
Let's do it.
I'm here at the tight door.
Cause when I take you, girl, you and me are gonna become like one person on the dance floor.
Ooh. See, that's not even really physically positive, so I gotta take off points there for truthfulness.
Oh, no. Let me show you. Can we get beat?
Пушка басколбасит соло, колбасер по пояс голый.
Sorry, no one wins this round. Join us next time. Don't date my mom.
Can I get your number, please?
No.
We'll call you.
Does that mean you're passing the show?
Probably.
Great, because I don't want to do this again. Come on, Mom.
What is the edgiest, most groundbreaking show you could possibly imagine? Don't even answer that, because it's about to get even edgier and even more groundbreaking.
Well, remember, we are on network television.
Prepare yourselves for the edgiest, most groundbreaking show on network television, so it can't contain bad language, excessive violence, or anything else that makes cable shows so much more awesome. Prepare yourselves for the Altos.
Am I a mom boss? Yes. But does that make me a bad mother? No. I often read my son's kindergarten class.
And today, we have Lorenzo's mommy. She's going to be reading to us today. Yay, can we clap for her?
This is life, and this is how it is. And no, this is not Skippy John Jones. I mean, come on. He's a chihuahua who thinks he's a Siamese cat. Let me get something straight. Dogs don't wear clothes. They don't, except for some breeds, on Halloween and in the winter. But besides that, they don't wear clothes. The Godfather has passion. It has drama. It has thrill. Playtime is over, kids. All right, chapter one.
And that's all the time we have for today. Thank you so much, Lorenzo's mommy.
I'm not done.
Well, it's almost snack time, so.
They can't snack without green.
That's not how we do things here.
Well, maybe you should leave the game when you do things here. Have you ever thought of that?
Okay, well.
Why don't you just sit over there, and anytime you feel like moving back over here, you can just imagine yourself sinking to the bottom of the ocean. Can you do that? Can you use your imagination?
What?
We'll call you.
You will. Call me.
We will try.
You think that was fiction? That wasn't fiction, all right? That was real life.
Great. That's wonderful.
So you can either do my show or learn how to swim in cement boots. Okay? Guess what? Your head is going to be home to about 20 different kinds of scavenging fish. Okay? They eat the eyes first, then they burrow in like it's a coral reef.
Thanks.
Please leave.
What?
Leave.
Get off the set.
Go away.
I can't take it. Television's run out of good ideas.
If you know what's good,
get out! Out!
System. The recording of this production is absolutely prohibited. There will be 2 10-minute intermissions through the course of this performance. In the case of an emergency, please locate the nearest possible exit. We would like to thank our 2018-2019 main stage presenting sponsors, Frederick Motorsports and Grace of Indio Restaurant, located here in Urbana. We would now like you to sit back, laugh, and enjoy Noises Off. Thank you.
in sardines and answer the phone. I've only got one pair of feet. Hello? Yes, but there's no one here, love. No, Mr. Brent's not here. He lives here, yeah, but he don't live here now because he lives in Spain. Mr. Philip Brent, that's right. Yep, the one who writes the plays, that's him, only now he writes them in Spain. No, she's in Spain too. They're all in Spain, there's no one here. Am I in Spain? No, I'm not in Spain, dear. I look after the house for them. But I go home at 1 o'clock on Wednesday, only I've got a nice plate of sardines to put my feet up with, because it's de Royal, what's it called on the telly? De Royal, you know, where's the paper then? And if it's to do with letting the house, then you'll have to ring the house agents because they're the agents for the house. Squire, Squire, recommend, oh, John, who's the other one? No, they're not in Spain, dear. The next set of phone in the statue. Squire, Squire, recommend, oh, John, I'll go look. Always the same, isn't it? Soon as you take the weight off your feet, down it all comes on your head. And I take the sardines. No, I leave the sardines. No, I take the sardines.
You leave the sardines and you put the receiver back.
Right, yes, okay, so I put the receiver back.
And you leave the sardines.
And I leave the sardines.
You leave the sardines.
I put the receiver back and I leave the sardines.
Right.
We've changed that, have we, love?
No, love.
That's what I've always been doing.
I shouldn't say that, Dotty, my precious.
How about the words? Am I getting some of them right?
Some of them have a very familiar ring.
Only it's like a slot machine in there.
I know that, Dotty.
I open my mouth and I never know if it's going to come out one lemon, or two oranges, and a banana.
Anyway, it's not midnight yet, and we don't open till tomorrow. So there you are, holding the receiver.
So there I am, holding the receiver.
Squire, Squire Hackerman, hold on, and noises off.
Squire, Squire Hackerman, hold on, don't go away, I'm putting it down. Always the same, isn't it? Put your feet up for 2 minutes and then they come running after you.
Hold it.
The housekeeper, yes, but this
hold
is
it, Gary. Dotty! Hold it, Brooke. Dotty!
Come back!
Yes, and go out again with the newspaper.
The newspaper? Oh, right, okay, yes, the newspaper.
You leave the sardines, you put the receiver back, and you go out with the newspaper.
Here you are, love.
Oh, sorry, love.
Don't worry, love, it's only the technical.
It's the dress, Gary Hun. It's the dress rehearsal.
So, when was the technical?
When's the dress? We open tomorrow.
I mean, we're all of us thinking of it as the technical, aren't we, love?
It's all those words, my sweetheart.
Don't worry about the words, Dotty, my pet.
Coming up like oranges and lemons.
Listen, Dotty, your words are fine. Your words are better than the... Do you know what I mean? I mean, isn't that right?
Sorry?
Okay, Gary. So you and Brooke are off, and Dotty's holding the receiver.
Okay, so he's the... All right, but Dotty, listen, you've been playing this sort of role for, well, do you know what I mean?
Okay, Gary. So you and Brooke are off.
No, but here we are. We're all thinking, my God, we open tomorrow. We don't know where we are, but my God, here we are.
That's right, my sweet. Isn't that right, Lloyd?
Beautifully put, Gary. Yes.
And look, we've got to play Western Supermale of this week, then Yorville, and then God knows where, and God knows where else. And we're all of us feeling pretty much, I mean, aren't you?
Sorry?
Okay, Gary. Yeah. So you're off.
Thanks, Lloyd.
Okay, Gary.
Lloyd, let me just say one more thing since we stopped. I've worked with a lot of directors, Lloyd, and well, some of them were geniuses and some of them were bastards, but I've never met one who was so totally, absolutely, I don't know.
Thank you, Gary. I'm very touched. Now will you get off my bloody stage? And Brooke?
Yes?
Are you in?
In.
Are you there?
What?
You're out? Okay, I'll call later. So there you are, holding the receiver.
So there I am, holding the receiver. I put the receiver back, I leave the sardines. Always the same, isn't
it? And you go out with the newspaper.
No. What are you? All right. So I leave the sardines, I take the newspaper. Always the same, isn't it?
It's leaving the receiver!
I have a housekeeper, yes, but this is her afternoon off, so we've got the place entirely to ourselves. I'll just check. Hello? Is anyone at home? No, there's no one here. So what do you think?
Great, and this is all yours?
Oh, yes, well, just a little shack in the woods, really. Converted posset mill, 16th century.
It must have cost a bomb.
Yes, well, one has to have someone to entertain one's business associates. Someone coming at 4 o'clock, in fact. Arab chic, oil, you know.
Right, and I've got to get those files down to Basingstoke by 4.
Yes, we'll only just manage to fit it in. I mean, we'll only just do it. I mean, well...
Right, then.
We won't bother to chill the champagne.
All these doors?
Oh, just a handful, really. A kitchen, study, and a self-contained service flat for the housekeeper.
And which one's the...
What?
Oh, you know.
Oh, the usual offices through here.
Fantastic.
Daddy!
Oh, oh.
I'm sorry, I thought there was no one here.
I'm not here. I'm off. Only it's the royal, you know, where they wear those hats and they're all covered in fruit. And who are you?
I'm from the agents.
From the agents?
Squire Hackham and Dudley.
Which one are you then, Squire Hackham or Dudley?
I'm Tramplemane.
Walking in here as if you owned a place. I thought you was a burglar.
No, I just dropped in to go into a few things. Oh, well, to check some of the measurements. To do one or two odd jobs. And a client. I'm showing a prospective tenant through the house.
What's wrong with this door?
She's thinking of renting it. Her interest is definitely aroused.
That's not the bedroom.
The bedroom, no, that's the downstairs bathroom in WC suite, and this is the housekeeper, Mrs. Crockett.
Clackett, dear, Clackett.
Oh, hi.
She's not really here.
Only it's the royal, you know, with the hands.
We'll just inspect the house.
I'll have the sound on low.
Don't worry about us.
Only now I've lost the newspaper.
Sardines. I'm sorry about this.
That's all right, we don't have the television, do we?
Sardines!
I've forgotten the sardines.
Lloyd. These damn sardines, they're driving us all mad.
Is there something wrong with the sardines, Gary? Poppy!
There's 4 plates of sardines coming on in Act 1 alone. They go here, they go there, she takes them, I take them. I mean, we're all of us feeling pretty much, I mean, aren't you?
Sorry?
The sardines.
What sardines?
The sardines?
Yes, would you make Gary 4 plates of mashed banana?
No, Lord, we don't want 4 plates of mashed banana.
Okay. It's all right for you. You're out there. We're up here. We've got to do it. Plus, we've got words. We've got doors. We've got bags. We've got boxes. I mean, we're all of us feeling pretty much... I mean, do you know what I mean?
We're not getting at you, Poppy, love. We think the sardines are lovely.
So, yes. What do you want to change, Gary? The bags, the boxes, the doors?
We can't just start changing things now, love.
Look, all I'm saying is words, doors, bags, boxes... Sardines. Us. Okay? I've made my point.
Yes.
You certainly have, Gary. Got oh, that, Poppy.
Well,
Right, on we go. And Poppy, love.
Yeah?
Don't let this happen again.
No.
Sorry, Lloyd, but sometimes you just got to. Do you know what I mean?
Of course.
Better out than, you know.
Much better. As long as Dottie's happy.
Absolutely happy, Lloyd, my love.
Will you do something for me then, Dottie, my precious?
Anything, Lloyd, my sweet.
Take the sardines off with you.
I'm sorry about this.
That's all right. We don't want the television, do we?
Only she's been in the family for generations.
Right, and I've got to get those files down to Basingstoke by 4.
Well, perhaps we should just have a glass of champagne.
We'll take it up with us.
Yes, well...
And don't let my files out of sight.
No, only...
What?
Well...
Her?
She has been in the family for generations.
Sardines? Oh, it's not for me to say, of course, dear. Only I would just say this. Don't think twice about it. Take the plunge. You'll really enjoy it here.
Oh, great.
Won't she, love?
Yes, well, yes.
And we'll enjoy having her. Won't we, love?
Yes, well, yes.
Terrific.
Sardines. You can't put your feet up on an empty stomach, can ya? Okay.
You see? She thinks it's great. She's even making us sardines.
Well?
I think she's terrific.
Terrific.
So, which way?
All right, before she comes back with the sardines.
Up here?
Yes, yes.
In here?
Yes, yes, yes.
It's another bathroom.
Oh, no, right there.
Always trying to get me into bathrooms.
Yes, just in here.
Oh, black sheets.
Oh, it's the linen closet. This one.
Oh, you're in a real state. You can't even get the door open.
No, it's Miss Clackett's afternoon off. Remember, we've got the place entirely to ourselves.
Hold it. And God said, hold it. And they held it. And God saw that it was terrible.
But sorry, loves, the store won't open.
Oh, sorry, loves, the store won't close.
And God said, Poppy!
Sorry, everyone, am I doing something wrong?
Oh, no, Freddy.
You know
Freddy.
How stupid I am about doors.
You're doing it perfectly.
As long as it's not me who's broken it.
Ah, and there the hell was Poppy. And God said, be fruitful and multiply. And fetched him to fix the doors.
Oh, I love technicals.
She loves technicals. I mean, honestly, well, Dottie, where's Dottie?
Everyone's always so nice to one another.
She really thinks that, well, Belinda's being all, do you know what I mean?
Oh, Freddy, don't you like an all-night technical?
The only thing I like about technicals is you get a chance to sit on the furniture.
Oh, Freddy, it's so good to see you cheering up and making jokes.
Was that a joke?
This is such a lovely company to work with. Such a happy company.
Wait till we've got to Stockton-on-Tees in 12 weeks' time.
What's wrong, Lloyd, my love?
Well, I'm starting to know what God felt like when he sat there in the darkness, creating the world.
Oh, what did he feel like?
Very pleased he'd taken his value.
Right, well, he had 6 hours of course, 6 days, of course, we only have 6 hours.
And God said, where the hell is Tim? And there the hell was Tim. And God said, let there be doors that open when they open, Tim, and close when they close.
Do something?
Doors.
I was doing the front of house.
Doors!
Doors?
Tim, are you fully awake?
Tim, love, this door won't close.
Yes, and the bedroom won't, you know what I mean?
Oh, right.
He hasn't been to bed in 48 hours.
Don't worry, Tim. Only another 24 hours, and it'll be the end of the day.
Oh, look, he's come to Earth among us.
Look, so since it took 2 days to get this set up, we shan't have time for a dress rehearsal. Don't worry, just think of the first night as the dress rehearsal. I mean, if we can just get through this play once tonight for Dolls and Sardines. That, you know, that's what it's all about, Dolls and Sardines. Getting on, getting off. Getting the sardines on, getting the sardines off. That's farce. That's theater. That's life.
Oh, Lloyd, you're so deep.
So just keep going. Bang, bang, bang.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Dolls.
Bang, you're on, bang, you've done it, and bang, you're off. And everything will go perfect. Where's Selsden?
Selsden?
Oh, Poppy!
Lloyd, I thought he was in front with you!
I thought he was around the back with you. Is Mr. Mowbray in his dressing room?
Oh, I don't think he would. Not to the technical, would he?
What, who?
Selsden, we can't find him.
Oh, I don't think he would. Not to the technical.
Half a chance he would.
Would what? Oh, my sweets, be fair, we don't know.
Let's not jump to any conclusions.
Let's get the understudy dressed. Tim!
Yes?
You're going on as the burglar.
Oh, right.
Lloyd, I said he must never be out of sight.
Oh, but he's been good as gold all through rehearsals.
Well, yes, but that's because in the rehearsal room it was, well, I don't know, but yes. There we were, that's and do you know what I mean?
There was no set. You could see everyone.
Yes, and here it's all, well, back there and, well, of course, up here.
Back and the front.
Yes, of course.
And instantly we've lost.
You've not dressed through.
And you've checked in the lavatories.
Yes.
And in the scenery dock and the paint room and the prop store.
Yes.
Yeah, you've worked with him before, of course.
All right, ring the police.
The police.
Finish with those doors. Get the gear on. It's my fault, not my love.
No, it's my fault, Lloyd.
I cast him.
Let's give him one last chance, I said. One last chance. I mean, what can you do? We win weekly rap together at Peebles.
It's my fault, Dottie. I shouldn't have let you. I mean, this show for her, it's more than just... this is her life savings.
We know that, Gary, love.
I'm not trying to make my fortune.
Of course you're not, Dottie.
I just wanted to... put a little something by.
We know, love.
Just enough to, well, buy a little house. I mean, well, do you know what I mean? That's not too much to ask.
Oh, Brooke, don't cry. It's not your fault.
Oh, no, I've got something behind my lens.
Yes, you can expect Brooke to keep anyone in sight.
But he was standing right there in the stalls before we started. I saw him.
Oh, well, who are we talking about now?
Oh, don't worry. You know you can't see anything.
You mean Selsden? I'm not blind. I can see Selsden.
Selsden!
Oh my God, he's been here the whole time.
Standing there like Hamlet's father.
My word, Selsden, you gave us such a surprise. We thought you were... Oh, not there.
Where have you been, Selsden?
Are you all right, Selsden?
Speak to us!
Is it a party?
Is it a party?
Is it? How killing. I got my head, we're going to have a spa rehearsal. Help me out, love.
Oh God.
Oh, dear God. Thought to have a snooze, they're back in the stalls to be ready for rehearsal.
Isn't he lovely?
Much lovelier, now that we can see him!
So, what are we celebrating?
What are we celebrating?
I've looked all through the wardrobe and the dressing rooms and I can't find the gear. Oh.
You said the beer's in the wardrobe?
No, Tim, you need a break. Go down quietly upstairs and do the company's payroll.
Payroll, right.
And Tim, if he and the gear do walk off together one night, I need you to order yourself a spare burglar costume.
Spare burglar costume?
Two spare burglars. I won't fit you and won't fit Poppy. I want spare burglars on hand for any eventuality.
Two spare burglars.
Lloyd, he hasn't been to bed in 2 days.
Don't fall down, Tim. We might not be insured.
So, what's on the schedule for today?
Well, Selsdon, I thought we might try a spot of rehearsal.
Oh, I won't, thank you.
You won't?
No, you all go on ahead. I'll be on the stores watching. You said the beer's in the wardrobe, isn't it?
No, he wants us to rehearse.
Yes, but I thought we ought to rehearse, haven't we?
Ah, yes. Well done, Selsdon. I knew you would think of something. Right, on we go.
Lloyd.
What?
The police.
The police?
Yes, they said they found an old man lying just across the street unconscious.
No, Poppy, no.
They say he's very dirty and rather smelly, and I thought, my God, because if you get anywhere close to Selsdon.
Poppy.
Anywhere near Selsdon, you can't help but notice his very distinctive.
I'll tell you something, Poppy. Once you got in your nostrils, you never forget it. 60 years now, and the smell of the theater still haunts me.
Bless him.
Poppy, love, tell me, how did you get a job like this that requires tact and understanding? You're not somebody's girlfriend, are you?
Oh, Poppy, don't worry, he truly didn't hear.
Not hear?
Yes, yes, there.
Sit down, my precious.
Go back to sleep, love.
You're not on for another 20 pages yet. Right, on we go. Dirty in the kitchen, wildly roasting sardines, Freddie and Belinda waiting impatiently outside the front door, and Gary and Brooke upstairs disappearing tremulously into the bedrooms. Time sliding irrevocably into the past.
Aren't they sweet?
What?
Gary and Dottie.
Gary and Dottie? What? Those two? They're an item? It's Trampelmane and Mrs. Clackett.
Yeah, it's supposed to be a secret.
But she's old enough to be...
Didn't you know?
I'm just God, Belinda, love. I'm just the one with the English degree. I don't know anything.
What's happening?
I shouldn't like to imagine, Gary, hon.
Well, I mean, what are we waiting for?
I don't know what you're waiting for, Gary. Her 18th birthday... Or maybe just the queue. Brooke, oh, you're in a real state.
Oh, you're in a real state. You can't even get the door open.
Door closed.
You can't even get the door open.
No, it's Miss Clackett's afternoon off. Remember, we've got the place entirely to ourselves.
Home.
Home, sweet home.
Dear old house.
Just waiting for us to come back.
It's rather odd, though, sneaking in like this on our wedding anniversary.
If Inland Revenue finds out we're in the country, even for one night, Bango's claimed a resident abroad. Bango's most of last year's income. I feel like an illegal immigrant.
I'll tell you what I feel like.
Champagne?
I wonder if Miss Clackett has... aired the beds.
Darling.
Oh, why not? No children, no friends dropping in. We're absolutely on our own.
True. There's something to be said about being a tax exile.
Oh, leave those. What?
Inland Revenue may hear us.
What I did with that first lot of sardines, I should never know.
Miss Clackett!
You gave me a turn. My heart jumped right out to my boots.
So did mine.
We thought you'd gone. I thought she was in Spain.
We are.
You haven't seen us.
We're not here.
Oh, it's like that, is it? The income tax is after you.
Oh, they would be if they knew we were here.
All right, then, love, you're not here. I haven't seen anything. Off to bed, are you?
Oh.
Well.
Yeah, no, that's all right. No, we're not bed, but he'll get on top of you. No, you want your things, look.
Oh. Yes, thanks.
Oh, and that bed hasn't been aired, love.
I'll get the hot water bottle.
And I've put all your letters in the study, dear.
That is what letters you forward all my mail, don't you?
Not the one from the income tax, dear. Don't want to spoil your holiday.
Oh, good heavens, where are they?
I'll put them all in the pigeon house.
In that pigeon house?
Yes, in the pigeon house, in your desk, love. I'll show you. Come on.
Yes, but I hear voices.
Voices? What sort of voices?
Hold it! Freddie, what's the trouble?
Lloyd, you know how stupid I am about my moves. Sorry, Gary, sorry, Brooke, it's just my usual dimness. But why do I carry the things off into the study? Wouldn't it be more natural if I left them on?
No.
I thought it might be somehow more logical.
No.
Listen, Lloyd, I know it's a bit late in the day to go into all this.
No, Freddy, we've several more minutes left before we open.
Thank you, Lloyd, as long as you're not too pushed. But I never quite understood why he carried an overnight bag and a box of groceries into the study to look at his mail.
Because they have to be out of the way for my next scene.
I see that.
Where's Selsdon? Is he there?
Selsdon?
No bars, no burglar alarms. They ought to be prosecuted for incitement. No?
No, not yet. Thank you, Selsdon.
I thought I heard my name.
No. Back to sleep. You're not on for another 10 pages yet.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Not at all. Nice to see you. Poppy! Put the glass back once more. And Selsdon.
Yes?
Beautiful performance.
Oh, thank you. I don't think it's quite there yet, though.
He even remembered the line.
All right, I see all that.
The love of God.
I just don't understand why I take them.
Freddy, honey, why does anyone do anything? Why does that other idiot walk out of the front door holding two plates of sardines? I'm not getting at you, love.
Yes, well, of course not, love. But, I mean, if you think about it, why do I? I mean, if you really think about it, why do I?
Who knows? The wellsprings of human action are deep and cloudy. Now, Freddy, sweetheart, maybe something happened to you. As a very small child, which left you frightened to let go of groceries.
Or it could be genetic.
Yes, or it could be, you know.
I think it's that.
It could well be.
Yes, I understand all that.
Freddy, honey, I'm telling you, I don't know. I don't think the author knows. I don't know why this author came to this industry in the first place. I don't know why any of us came into it at all.
But if you could just give me a reason that I could keep in my mind.
All right, Freddy. I'll give you a reason.
Okay.
You carry those groceries into the study, Freddy, honey, because it's just slightly after midnight.
Yes.
And we're not going to be finished before we open tomorrow night. Okay. Correction, before we open tonight! So on we go from Freddy's exit with the groceries.
Lloyd, sweetheart.
What?
His wife left him this morning.
Freddy, sweetheart. Well, I think the point that I'm trying to make is, well, you've had a great fright when she mentions the income tax, and, well, you feel very insecure and exposed, and you're looking for something familiar to hold on to.
Thank you, Lloyd. That's most helpful.
Okay, Freddy. Easy. Easy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, right. Sorry.
Bless you, my sweet.
And on we merrily go.
Yes, but I could hear voices.
Voices? What sorts of voices?
Well, people's voices.
But there's no one here.
Darling, I saw the door handle move. It could be someone from the office checking up.
Well, I still don't see why you've got to put your tie on to go look.
Mrs. Crackett.
Mrs. Crackett.
One has to set an example to the staff.
Oh, look, she's opened our sardines.
No, come back.
What?
You can't go downstairs like that.
Well, why not?
Mrs. Crackett.
Mrs. Crackett.
One has certain obligations.
Sardines here, sardines there. It's like a Sunday school outing. You're still poking around, are you?
Yes, still poking. Well, still around.
In the linen closet, were you?
Yes, well, I was just checking the inventory, making sure the sheets were all, well, Miss Blackett.
Clackett, dear, Clackett.
Yes, Mrs. Clackett. Is there anyone else in the house, Mrs. Clackett?
I haven't seen no one, dear. No.
I thought I heard voices.
Voices! There's no voices here, love, no.
I must have imagined it.
Yes.
Oh, good Lord above!
I beg your pardon.
Oh, good Lord above! Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, and the study door is open! Oh, good Lord!
Hold on, there's another car outside! That's not Mr. Hackham's, is it? Or Mr. Dudley's?
Oh, there is nothing but flapping doors in this house.
Notice steps will be taken. Distraint. Proceedings in court.
Oh, yes, and that reminds me, a gentleman came about the house.
Don't tell me I'm not here.
He say he got a lady quite around.
Leave everything to Squire Hackham and Dudley.
I'll let them go all over then, shall
let
I?
Let them do whatever, just so long as you don't tell them we're here.
All right, then, love, so I'll just sit down and turn on the sardines. I've forgotten the sardines. I don't know if it was at fixed tomorrow's shoulders. I forget what day it was.
I didn't get this. I'm not here. I'm in Spain. But if I didn't get it, I didn't open it.
Darling, I never had a dress like this, did I?
Didn't you?
No, I never buy anything as tarty as this. It's not something you gave me, was it?
I should never have touched this.
Well, it's lovely.
Stick it down, put it back. Never saw it.
I'll put it in the attic with all the other lovely things you gave me.
All right, all right. Now the study door's open again. What's going on? Knocking? Knocking? What the? Oh my God, there's something in the linen closet. Oh, it's you.
Of course it's me. You put me in here in the dark with all the black sheets and things.
Yes, but darling, why did you lock the door?
Why did I lock the door? Why did you lock the door?
I didn't lock the door.
Someone locked the door.
Well, we can't just stand here like this.
But like what?
In your nightgown.
Okay, I'll take it off.
Oh no, in here, in here.
Darling, this glue, is it the sort you can never get unstuck?
Hold it.
Oh, look, Miss Clack has made us some sardines.
Hold it, we have a problem.
Oh, good heavens, which one is it this time?
Left!
It's the left one, everybody.
It could be anywhere.
Yes, it could have fallen over the thing and then bounced somewhere else. Do you know what I mean?
I see it.
Well, it must have been on. Why did I lock the door? She opens her eyes very sort of, and I always...
Yes, everyone look under their feet.
Nobody move their feet.
Everyone put their feet back exactly where they were.
Okay. I came from this the start. This, and I came back here, and I picked up the side and like this. Everyone pick up their feet one by one.
Yes.
Brooke, is this going to happen during a performance? We don't want the audiences to miss their last buses and trains.
Oh, she'll just keep going, won't she, my love?
But can she see anything without them?
Can she hear anything without them?
Sorry? Oh, sorry! Sorry! Oh, dear. My poor darling! You stepped on his foot!
What's the matter with him?
Oh, he's just got a little nosebleed, that's all.
A nosebleed? Nobody touched him.
Yeah, he's got this thing about violence. It always makes his nose bleed.
Brooke, sweetheart.
Oh, I thought you said something to me.
Yes, just go hit the box office manager with this and it'll finish off live theatre in London.
Anyways, I found it. She's found it.
Where was it, love?
In my eye.
In her eye.
Not in your left eye, was it?
Well, it had gone around the sides. I knew it hadn't gone far. Pop, are you okay?
So,
Freddy?
Yes. Oh, dear.
What happened to him this time?
He has this thing about...
A thing about what?
Well, I won't say the word.
You mean blood?
Oh, dear.
Right. Clear the stage. Walking wounded, carry the stretcher cases, and on we bloodily stagger. Sorry, Freddy. On we blindly stumble. Brooke, I withdraw that. Anyways, from your exit, can't stand here like this. Like what? In your nightgown? Okay, I'll take it. Where's Selsden?
Oh, Sel's done.
Dropped it out here somewhere.
Good. Keep looking. Only another 5 pages before the big moment. From your exit, anyway. I'll take it off.
In here.
Darling, this glue, is it the sort you can never get unstuck? Oh, look, Miss Clack made us some sardines.
Now what?
A hot water bottle? I didn't put it there.
Well, I didn't put it there.
Someone in the bathroom filling hot water bottles.
You don't think there's something creepy going on here?
Darling, are you coming to bed or aren't you?
What did you say?
I didn't say anything.
First the door handle, now this hot water bottle.
I can feel goose pimples all over.
Oh, yes, quick, let's get something around you.
Quick, get the covers over our heads.
What did I do with those sardines? You wait here.
You hear all sorts of funny things about these old houses.
Yes, of course, but this one has been extensively modernized throughout. I don't see how anything creepy would survive oil fire.
What is it? What's happening?
The sardines. They've gone.
Perhaps there is something creepy going on. I'm going to get in bed and put my head under the...
I put them there. Or, well, maybe it was there.
Bag.
Well, of course, Mrs. Splodgett might have taken them and put them somewhere. What is it?
Bag.
Bag?
Bag.
What do you mean, bag?
Bag.
What do you mean, bag? Bag.
Bag.
Bag. What bag?
Bag.
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 What bag?
No bag.
No bag.
Your bag suddenly here, now gone.
Oh well, it's in the bedroom. I put it in the bedroom.
No, don't go in there.
The box. They've both gone.
Oh my files!
What on earth's happening? Where's Mrs. Sprotchett? You wait in the bedroom.
No.
At least put your dress on.
I'm not going in there.
I'll fetch it for you.
Yes, quick, let's get out of here.
Your dress is gone.
I'm never going to see Basingstoke again.
Don't panic. Just don't panic. There's some perfectly rational explanation for all of this. I'll just Fetch Mrs. Blotchett and she'll tell us what's happening. You wait here. You can't wait here like this. No, you wait in the study. Study, study, study.
Ah! Ah! Roger, there's someone in there! Where are you?
Darling, I know this is going to sound silly, but...
Darling, if you're not coming to bed, I'm going to clear out the attic.
Darling, I can't come to bed. I'm glued to a tax demand.
Oh, darling, why don't you try putting the sardines down?
Darling, I'm stuck to the sardines.
Oh, darling, don't play a fool. Get the bottle-marked poison in the downstairs loo. That eats through anything.
I've heard of people getting stuck with the problem, but this is ridiculous.
Selsdon! We're there, Selsdon. The moment has arrived.
He's coming, it's all right.
But Azam should be coming through that window even before Freddy's off. Here it is.
No bars, no burglar alarms. They ought to be prosecuted for incitement.
Thank you, Selsdon.
No, but sometimes it makes you want to sit down and weep. I used to do banks. When I remember, I used to do bullion vaults.
What am I doing now?
I'm breaking the paper bag.
Wait, my precious.
Stop.
It's like the band playing on as the Titanic sank. Thank you, Belinda. Thank you, Poppy.
Just had seen that movie.
I think you can hear better than I can.
I beg your pardon.
Film your entrance, please, Selsdon.
And when she said, I'll never let go.
Thank you. Poppy!
Oh, not for me, thank you. It stops me sleeping.
Put the glass back once more.
Come on again?
Yes, only Selsdon.
Yes?
A little bit sooner, Selsdon. A shade earlier. A touch closer to yesterday. And I want your arm coming through that window as... Well, Freddy, what's the line?
I've heard of people getting stuck with the problem, but it's ridiculous.
I want your arm going through that window as soon as you hear the line. I've heard of people getting stuck with a problem.
Stuck with a problem?
Stuck with a problem, but this is ridiculous.
What?
And I want your arm going through that window, right?
Yes, might I make a suggestion, though? Should I perhaps come on a little bit sooner?
Selsdon.
You see, there's something behind us between his exit and my entrance.
Don't worry, Selsdon. I've got it. How about coming on a little bit sooner?
I see we're thinking along the same lines.
Am I putting him on, or is he putting me on? Right, Freddy, from your exit.
I've heard of people getting stuck with a problem! But this is ridiculous.
No bars, no burglar alarms. They ought to be prosecuted for incitement. No, but sometimes it makes me want to sit down and weep. When I think I used to do banks. When I remember, I used to do bullion vaults. What am I doing now? I'm breaking into paper bags. So, what have we got here? One microwave oven? What? 50 quid? Hardly worth lifting it. Junk. If you insist. Now, where's his desk? No, they all say the same thing, really. They all say the same thing. Yes? Line?
It's hard just to retirement.
What?
It's hard to adjust to retirement.
It's hard to what?
Adjust to retirement!
It's also hard to hear when you all talk at the same time.
And it naturally wishes to know if there's any history of paranormal phenomena.
Oh yes, dear, it's all nice and paranormal.
I mean, has anything ever dematerialized before? Has anything ever flown about?
Flown about? No, things just... They move themselves on their own 2 feet. Just
I better warn them.
Even like they do in any house.
I better warn the prospective tenant. She's inspecting the study. Oh my God! There's a man in there.
No! There's no one in the house, love.
No, look, he's searching for something.
I can't see no one, dear.
Well, you can't see him, but this is remarkable. And where's my prospective? Oh my God!
Now what?
There. The sardines.
Oh, the sardines.
You can see the sardines?
Yes, I can see the sardines.
I'm not letting these sardines out of my hand, but where's my prospective tenant?
I'm going to be opening sardines all night, in and out here like a cuckoo on a clock.
Vicky!
No, but I'll miss the violence. I miss having other human beings around to terrify.
Where's she gone? Vicky!
No, you really miss all the shouting and screaming. All this silence gets you down.
Vicky!
I'm going to end up talking to myself.
Darling, this stuff that goes on and needs to do anything, it eats through trousers. Darling, you don't think that if it goes on, it needs to do trousers, it needs to do... Darling, I think you better help me get these pants off. Darling, help! I think I can feel it! It's eating through absolutely everything!
There's something evil in this house.
The Inland Revenue.
He's back.
I'm not here.
He's not there.
I'm abroad.
He's walking abroad.
I must go.
Stay.
I won't, thank you.
Speak.
Only in the presence of my lawyer.
Only in the presence of your... Hold on, you're not from the other world.
Yes, yes, Barcelona.
You're some kind of intruder. You've done something to Vicky.
Well, nice to meet you. I mean, have a sardine.
No, you're not. You're some kind of sex maniac.
Well, I see that you already have a plate of sardines, so if there's nothing else I can offer you...
This is plainly a matter for the police.
How'd you feel running along?
No, come back. Hello, police? Someone has broken into my house. Or rather, someone has broken into someone's house. No, but he's a sex maniac. There was a young woman here, and what's happened to her, no one knows.
There's a man lurking in the undergrowth!
The young woman has reappeared. Are you all right?
No, he almost saw me.
He almost saw her. Yes, but he's a burglar as well. He's taken our things.
Oh, but the things are here.
The things have come back, so we're just missing a plate of sardines.
Well, here are the sardines.
And we've found the sardines.
Is this the police? You want the police here? In my nightgown?
So what am I saying? I'm saying let's say no more about it. I thought something terrible had happened to you.
It has. I know him.
You know him?
He's been dealt with by our office.
No, he's just some ordinary sex maniac.
Well, yes, but you have to keep a certain standard when you work for the Inland Revenue.
Well, then why don't you just put something on?
Well, I haven't got anything.
Well, there must be something in the bathroom. Oh, bring the sardines.
Right, that's downstairs toilet up a bit. Just give the upstairs a quick going over for them.
A bath mat?
Better than nothing.
I can't go around in front of taxpayers wearing a bath mat.
Well, then there must be something in the bedroom.
I'm not going in there.
Fine, you look in the bathroom. I'll just look in the bedroom.
Darling, help! Where are you?
Roger, there's someone in the bathroom now! Where are you?
Darling, I'm finding such lovely things. Do you remember this China tea service that you gave me for our wedding anniversary?
Who are you?
Oh no, it's his wife, Independence!
Excuse me, I think you dropped your dress. Where have you been? Look at the state I'm in! Darling! Honestly, she just burst into the room and her dress fell off!
Here, put this sheet on for a moment while I see if there's something better in the attic.
One pair of silver taps. Oh my god!
Who are you?
Who am I? Fixing the taps.
Tux! Income tax.
That's right, Governor. Income new taps, out go taps.
Tax inspectors everywhere. The other one.
I found your dress. It just came flying out of the attic at me.
Darling, I've got her dress stuck to my head now.
Another intruder.
He's doing the taps, Governor.
A tax? Not a tax on women.
I'm trying to think, Governor. I'll go to the taps and the bath first.
Sex maniacs everywhere. Vicky!
My God, people everywhere. I'm off. A tax on women? I don't know. They put a tax in everything these days.
If I can't find her, you're going to be in trouble, you see.
WC, I'll fix it.
Where's she gone? Vicky!
Hey, darling!
Oh, chic. Well, I wasn't expecting you till 4. Well, it's almost 4 now, so, is this your charming wife? Well, since you're upstairs already...
Him and his floozy, I'll break this over their heads!
Or perhaps we should start downstairs.
Who are you? Who are these creatures?
Don't worry about her. She has no connection with the house, I assure you. Whereas this good lady, on the other hand...
No other hand, thank you. Not in my sardines, because this time I'm eating them.
...is fully occupied with her sardines.
Miss Clackett, who are these people?
Just Arab sheiks, love. We get them all the time.
So perhaps the bathroom facilities would be of more interest. In here...
Arab sheets!
In here we have...
Ball cocks, Governor. Your ball cocks have gone.
We have him.
They're not Arab sheets, they're Irish linen stolen off my own bed.
Oh, the thieving devils!
In the study, however.
You give me that sheet, you devil!
Oh, it's you.
It's her.
It's my little girl.
Dad?
It's a little Vicky who went away from home. I never thought I'd see you again.
What are you doing here like this?
What are you doing here like that?
Me? I'm tacking our taxes on evasion at the Inland Revenue in Basingstoke.
Oh.
So where's my other sheet?
Oh, House of Heavenly Peace, I rent it!
Hold on. Hold on, I know that face. He's no sheik. He's just that sex maniac.
Yes, that's my husband.
What?
You take all the clean sheets.
What?
You snatch my bath mat.
What?
You toss me aside like a broken china doll.
And what? To cap it all off, you've got your trousers around your ankles.
And what are you up to with my little girl down there in Basingstoke? Store?
Stop.
It's a question of authenticity, you see, Freddy, honey. Do Arab aristocrats wear trousers under their robes? I don't know. Maybe they do. But not around their ankles, Freddy. Not around their ankles.
Sorry, Lloyd. It's just frightfully difficult getting changed with that addresser.
Get Tim to help you. Tim! Where's Tim? Tim!
Oh, sorry.
Oh, yes. You're acting.
Yes, I must have fallen off down there.
Never mind, Tim.
Do something?
No, let it pass. We'll just struggle through on our own. Tim has to sleep behind the sofa while the rest of us walk around with trousers around our ankles. Sorry, Freddy, you'll just have to do the best you can. On we go. Is there some other problem, Freddy?
Well, since we're stopped anyway.
Why did I ask?
Lloyd, you know how stooped I am about plot.
Oh, I know.
May I ask another silly question?
All of my studies in the world of drama lie at your disposal.
Why does the sheik just happen to be Philip's double?
Oh, well, it's because, well, you see, he's the, well, do you know what I mean? I mean, that's the joke.
I see that.
The rest of the plot depends on it.
I see that, but it is rather a coincidence, isn't it?
It is rather a coincidence, Freddy. Until you reflect that there was an earlier draft of the play, now yet, unfortunately, lost to us. And in that, the author makes it perfectly clear that Philip's father, as a young man, traveled extensively in the Middle East.
I see!
You see?
That's very interesting.
I thought you would like that.
But will the audience get it?
You must tell them, Freddy, with looks and gestures. That's what acting's all about.
Thank you, Lloyd. That's most helpful.
And it will be even more powerful when you do it with no trousers.
Right. Poppy, can you help me here for a second?
Right. On we go. From Belinda's beautiful line. You toss me aside like a broken china doll. You know, I'm really being so clever out here. What's going to be left this show when I'm off in New York doing Richard III? You're left here on your own. Right. Anyways, on we go.
You toss me aside like a broken china doll!
And what are you up to with my little girl down there in Basingstoke, I won't ask. But I'll tell you one thing, Vicky.
Brooke?
Sorry?
Your line. Come on, love. We're one line away from the end of the act.
But I don't understand.
You don't... Poppy, give the line.
What's that, Dad? Well, yes, but I don't understand.
Your line, it's what's that, Dad?
Yes, I'll say to you, I'll tell you one thing, Vicky, and you say, what's that, Dad?
I don't understand why the sheik looks like Philip.
Poppy! Bring the book! Is that the line, Poppy, love? I don't understand why the sheik looks like Philip. Can we consult the author's text to make absolutely sure?
I think it's...
What's that, Dad? Right, that's the line, Brooke, love. We all know you've worked in some very classy places in London where they let you make the play up as you go along. But we don't want that kind of thing here, do we, love? Not when the author has provided us with such a considered and polished line of his own. Not at 1 o'clock in the morning. Not 2 lines away from the end of Act One. Not when we're all about to drop dead of exhaustion for a coffee break. We merely want to hear the line, what's that, Dad? Nothing else! I'm not being unreasonable, am I? Exit. Doesn't say exit. She's gonna watch where he lands.
Oh dear, I believe that this was all my fault, wasn't it?
A bit heavy with a sauce, I thought.
Yes, I thought it would be Poppy when he finally, well, you know.
It's usually Poppy, isn't it, love?
I thought it was rather sweet.
Sweet?
Yeah, them pretending to not have a little thing.
A little thing, Lloyd and Brooke.
Brooke and Lloyd?
Well, didn't you know? Where do you think they've been all weekend?
You mean to tell me that they were gone all weekend when poor old Tim...
Put the set up back to front.
Shh, they're coming.
All right. Always forgotten. I was irresistible.
Oh, no!
What now?
You mean
her too?
Great Scott!
Now that's something I didn't know.
I think I'm going to faint.
Oh, yes, sit down, love.
Oh, do your meditation.
Well, that's something she didn't know.
Shh. 2 weeks rehearsal, that's all we've had.
What's heaven next?
Most exciting.
Shh.
Oh, yes, shh.
Oh, here he comes. Is she all right, Lloyd?
Perfectly fine. Something she ate, probably.
Yes, well, this one's feeling a bit, well, you know.
I'm feeling a bit, you know, myself.
Oh, which one?
Faint?
Or sick?
Need that coffee break.
You're certainly overdoing it at the moment, love.
Can we just have the last bloody line of the act?
Right, yes, last line.
Yes,
right
here.
I don't know what you're up to with my little girl down there in Basingstoke, but I'll tell you one thing, Vicky.
What's that, Dad?
When all around is strife and uncertainty, there's nothing like a... What? There's nothing like a... What?
Like a good old-fashioned plate of...
There's nothing like a good old-fashioned plate of... What?
Sardines!
And curtains. Tim! Oh, curtains!
Gentlemen, Act One places, please. Your calls, Miss Otley, Miss Ashton, Mr. Lejeune, Mr. Fellows, Miss Blair. Act One places, please.
Act One places is what we'll get. What do you think?
Oh, Dottie will pull herself together by now. I mean, now she knows she has 5 minutes to be on stage, won't she?
Will she?
Oh, well, you know what Dottie's like.
We've only been on the road for a month. We've only gotten to Ashton-under-Lyne. What's it going to be like by the time we've got to Stockton-on-Tees?
If only she'd speak.
If only she'd say something. Look, if Dottie won't go on.
Won't go on?
If she won't.
She will.
Of course she will.
She won't she?
I'm sure she will. She will. But.
She must.
But if she didn't?
I'd have 5 minutes to change. 4 minutes.
Oh, if only she'd say something.
I'll give it another go. Get your mind off your own problems anyway.
Has she gone?
Lloyd, I didn't know you were coming in today.
I wasn't. I haven't.
Well, thank God that you're here.
I'm not. I'm in New York. I'm in the middle of rehearsing Richard III.
Dottie and Gary?
I don't want anyone to know I'm in.
Okay, well, Dottie and Gary, they,
Look, I just need 2 hours alone and undisturbed with Brooke in her dressing room. Then I'm on the 7:25 back to New York. Give this to Brooke. Do not let Selznick get his hands on it.
Great. Well, they've had some kind of row.
Good, good. Look, there's this little flower shop across the road from the stage door. I need you to go there and get me some very large and expensive-looking flowers.
Great. Well, she won't come out of her dressing room.
Don't let Poppy see them. They are not for Poppy.
Okay, and she won't speak to anyone.
Good, good. First house starts just after 5:30, yes, and second house finishes just after 7?
Lloyd, that's what I'm trying to tell you. There may not be a show.
Wait, she hasn't walked out already.
No one knows what she's doing. She's locked herself in a dressing room and she won't speak to anyone.
You've called places?
Yes.
I can't play a complete love scene from Cold Open in 5 minutes. It's not dramatically possible.
She's had bus stops with Gary before, of course.
Wait, Brooke's had a bus stop with Gary.
Brooke? Oh, not Brooke. Dottie.
Oh, Dottie, yeah, right.
There was the famous one the week before last when we were playing workshop.
Right, you told me on the phone, Tim.
She went out with this journalist, Flo.
Journalist? Yes.
Well, you know Gary threatened to kill him.
Killed him, yes. Tim, don't worry about Dottie. She's got money in the show.
Right, well, it's happened again. 2:00 this morning, I get a knocking on my door. It's Gary. Where's Dottie? She hasn't come home.
Look, Tim, let me tell you something about my life. I've got the Duke of Buckingham on the phone with me an hour every evening after rehearsal telling me that the Duke of Gloucester is sucking boiled sweets through speeches. The Duke of Clarence is off the entire week doing a commercial from Daria. Richard himself, would you believe, Richard III has now gone down with a back problem. I keep on getting messages from Brooke about how unhappy she is here. And now she's gone and gotten herself a doctor's certificate for nervous exhaustion. She's going to walk. I don't have time to find and rehearse another, Vicky. I just have one afternoon. While Richard is fitted for a surgical corset and to cure Brooke of her nervous exhaustion. With no medical aids, except for a little bit of whiskey, you've got the whiskey, and a few flowers, you've got the money for the flowers. And, well, a certain faded charm. So I haven't come to the theater to hear about your problems, Tim. I've come to be taken out of myself. And preferably, not put back again.
Yes, but Lloyd...
Have you done the front of house calls, Tim?
Oh, the front of house calls.
And don't let Poppy see those flowers.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please take your seats? The curtain will rise in 3 minutes.
We're going to be up so late.
No luck.
No, Belinda's having a go now. Money?
Oh.
Whiskey?
Oh, is it?
Where did you get this?
Oh, well,
Up here, you mean Selston's hiding them around stage now? I'll put in the ladies' bathroom, at least I know he won't go in there. No?
Oh, no.
He's hiding them around stage now. No?
No.
You didn't try for very long.
No, well, oh, dear.
He's hiding them on stage now.
Gary came rushing out of his dressing room in a great state. I couldn't quite understand what he was saying. I often feel I must have missed something with him somewhere because I think he was saying that he wanted to kill me.
Oh, Freddy, my precious.
And I thought I'd better leave him to it. I don't want to make him angrier. He's all right, is he?
Oh, who, Gary? Oh, anything but by the sound
I mean, he's going on, right?
Gary? What do you mean Gary's not going on? What's all this talk about Gary not going on? Of course Gary is going on.
Well, yes, because if you go on for Gary, then Poppy can't go on for Dottie, because if Poppy goes on for Dottie, then you have to be on book.
Oh, this is getting farcical.
Money.
Money?
You have money in your hand.
Oh. Oh, well, that's for,
Dottie's a funny woman, you know. So up and down, she was perfectly all right last night.
Last night?
Yes, we went out for a drink at some club she knows about after the show.
Wait, she was with you? You were with her?
Yes, she was being very sympathetic to all my troubles.
Oh, I won't let her sink her teeth into you.
No, she couldn't have been nice. In fact, we went to my digs afterwards for a cup of tea and talked all about her troubles, stayed up until 3 o'clock in the morning. I don't know what the landlady thought.
And another thing.
Nothing else, my precious.
Where's Selston?
Oh, well, it turns out here that Freddie is Selston?
He's not in the dressing rooms.
Oh, I might have guessed.
The front of house calls.
You do the calls and I'll look for Selston.
What shall I do?
Nothing.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please take your seats? The curtain will rise in 3 minutes.
He's going to kill someone.
Selston's going to kill someone?
Selston?
He's not in the dressing room.
Oh, not again.
Flowers?
Oh, well.
Oh, Tim, that's very sweet of you. Isn't it sweet of him?
Oh, very charming.
Here, you hold these. Okay. I'll go look in the pub for Selston.
I'll take those. Oh, the front of house calls.
Oh, dear, I think Poppy's done them.
Well, what'd you give them? 2 minutes? I'll give them a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please take your seats? The curtain will rise in 1 minute.
Oh, dear, I think she said 3 minutes.
She said 3 minutes? I said 3 minutes. Pia.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please take your seats? The curtain will rise in 2 minutes.
Any luck?
No, but I found yet another bottle in the woman's laboratory, would
you believe? Oxfam. I'll give it to Oxfam.
He's not pub.
No, he's hanging around women's laboratories.
Oh.
I'll go ahead and get the gear on.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please take your seats? The curtain will rise in 2 minutes.
Tim's done 2 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please take your seats? The curtain will rise in
what
1 minute.
What the hell is going on? Great Scott!
I didn't think you'd be here.
I'm not. I'm in New York. I'm in the middle of rehearsing Richard III.
Boy, there are great dramas going on.
We're having great dramas out there. This is a matinee, honey. There's old age pensioners out there. We all hear 3 minutes, we all go running to the gents. And then we hear 1 minute, and we all go rushing out again.
Okay, Lloyd,
We don't know which way we're going.
Lloyd, I've got to talk to you.
We're going to have a talk, my love.
Okay, well, did you get my messages?
Messages. Many, many messages.
Well, then why didn't you answer?
I did. I have. I'm here.
Okay, well, there's something I've got to tell you.
All right, come out with it then.
Well, I went to the doctor's today, and...
Later, yes, later.
In my dressing room.
In your dressing room? Lloyd, this is getting out of hand.
I'll give it to Oxfam with the other one.
I'll do it, thank you.
Oh, Lloyd!
Oh, sorry,
made it in one.
You got my message.
And came running, honey. And came running.
Lloyd, we have got to have a talk.
We're going to have a talk, my love.
When?
Later, yes, later. Flowers?
Oh, yes, here.
Yep, Tim bought them for me.
Tim bought them for you.
Cheer me up. Lloyd?
Nothing more, just for the moment. Thank you. Strangle Tim for me when you see him.
Right.
What about Selston?
I don't want to hear about Selston.
Oh, and Gary?
I don't want to hear about Gary, either.
What about Dottie?
Look, this show is beyond the help of any director. You just do it. I'll sit out there in the dark with a bag of gummy bears and enjoy myself. 1 minute was the last call. If your memory goes back that far...
Lloyd!
Wait!
Excuse me!
I've got to talk to him.
Girls.
I have a good mind to put my coat on and walk out that door right here and now.
Listen, if you don't feel up to performing, I'm sure Poppy would be happy to have a bash on your behalf.
I beg your pardon?
Honestly!
What did I do?
Why don't you go do your meditation, and Poppy, why don't you go find Gary and Dottie?
Freddy?
My precious.
Did I say something wrong?
Where's Tim?
Selsdon!
Are you all right? Oh, dear.
Where have you been, Selsdon? We've been looking everywhere for you.
Oh, yes, everywhere. In front, bar, manager's office, not a sign of him.
Oh, he's looking for you in the dressing room.
Oh, yes, a great shindig's been going on down there. I thought Tim ought to hear about it.
Oh, I think he already knows.
Oh, yes, everything. Oh, he really went for. I know, and you got your eye on someone.
Dottie's got her eye on someone, has she?
I've seen you creeping off into corners with that poor halfwit.
Which poor halfwit?
Oh, never mind.
Not Tim.
No, no, no.
But aside from me, who else is there?
I think they're coming. They're coming?
They're coming.
Oh, and you're here.
Oh, yes, everywhere.
Right, okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please take your seats? The performance is about to begin.
They're coming.
And we found Selsdon.
Oh, Selsdon, how did you get here?
How? Through the wall.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please take your seats? The performance is about to...
I've done it.
She did, I know.
You've done it?
Yes, about to begin.
The performance will begin... at any moment.
Lloyd is going to choke on his gummy
bear. Oh no, the wall's the very thing, you see. I'm absolutely sick to death of it, she cries. Am I setting a bit of a trend?
Oh,
understudy rehearsal.
Ah, yes, for Gary. Very timely of him. I know when you got your leg up for somebody.
Oh, Gary! Are you all right?
Is she all right? What's he saying?
Well, he's not saying anything.
Ah, very sensible of him. Only stirred up, he says. I've seen you give him little nods and smiles.
Are you all right?
Is she all right?
All right, everybody.
Little hugs and squeezes.
Curtain up.
Hold on, Poppy. Listen, Dottie. Listen, Gary. I'm not going to make a great speech. But we've all got to go out there and give a performance. And well...
What's the house like?
Well done, Dottie!
It's pretty good. Well, for a matinee, that is.
There's quite a bit of crowd at the front and the back of the orchestra.
Come on, old girl, get those tabs up. Those OAPs out there haven't got long to go.
Right, then quiet.
Hold on, Poppy, let me just say one more word.
Now let me just say one more word. Sardines!
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 Music cue one, tabs going up.
What?
No! Lloyd, we were just about to go up.
They've been sitting out there for an hour. They've gone quiet. They think someone's died.
Sorry, Lloyd. I was just saying a few words to everyone.
Freddy, have you ever considered getting a brain transplant?
Wrong moment. I see that.
Does anyone else have any thoughts they feel they must communicate?
Oh, well...
What?
Well, not now.
And you? You bought those flowers for Poppy.
No. Well, yes.
And you didn't buy any flowers for me.
No. Well, no.
Tim, have you heard of something called a jealous rage?
Yes. Well, yes.
Then take £10 of your own money, Tim, and go and buy some flowers for me.
Lloyd, we were just about to go up. I've got a show to run.
Forget the show. Focus solely on the floral arrangements. Bought them for Poppy. You two can have Freddy's old brain. Half inch!
Oh, dear.
Just get the old bus on the road.
Christ!
Quiet, Maxley!
Music cue one, go.
I'm all right. I'm fine. No! No, I can't! I can't! No!
No, Mr. Brunt's not here. He lives here, yeah, but he don't live here now because he lives in Spain. Mr. Philip Brunt, that's right. Yep, the one who writes the plays, that's him. Only now he writes them in Spain. No, she's in Spain too. They're all in Spain. There's no one here. Am I in Spain? No, I'm not in Spain, dear. I look after the house for them. But I go home at 1 o'clock on Wednesday, only I've got a nice plate of sardines to put my feet up with. Because it's Doroyal, what's it called on the telly? Doroyal, you know, I'm West of Piperden. Oh, and if it's to do with letting the house, then you'll have to ring the house agents because they're the agents for the house. Squire, Squire, Recommendo, wait, who's the other one? No, they're not in Spain, dear. The next set of phone in the study. Squire, Squire, Rackhamman, just so don't know, go look. Always the same, isn't it? Soon as you take the weight off your feet, down it all comes on your head.
But this is her afternoon off, so we've got the place entirely to ourselves. I'll just check. Hello? Is anyone at home? No. There's no one here, so what do you think?
Are these doors?
Oh, yes, well, there's only a handful, really. Kitchen. Study. And a self-contained service flat for the housekeeper.
And which one's the...
What?
Oh, you know.
The usual offices. Through here.
Fantastic.
Oh, okay. Now I've lost a sardine!
I'm sorry. I thought there was no one here.
I'm not here. I'm off. And you saw all you know where those hats and they're all covered in fruit, knew you?
I'm from the agents. Squire, Squire Hackerman Dudley. I'm Tramplemane. I just dropped in to go into a few things. Well, to do one or two odd jobs. To check some of the measurements. Oh, and a client. I'm showing a prospective tenant through the house. She's thinking of renting it. Her interest is definitely aroused.
That's not the bedroom.
The bedroom? No, that's the downstairs bathroom and WC suite. And this lovely lady is the housekeeper, Mrs. Crockett.
Clackett, dear, Clackett! Only now I've lost the newspaper.
I'm sorry about this.
That's all right. We don't want the television, do we?
Only she's been in the family for generations. Perhaps we should just have a glass of champagne.
We'll take it up with us.
Yes, no, well...
And don't let my files out of sight.
No, only...
What?
Well,
huh?
She's been in the family for generations.
It's not for me to say, of course, dear. Only I would just say this. Don't think twice about it. Take the plunge. You'll really enjoy it here.
Oh, great.
Won't you, love?
Yes, well, yes.
Sardines, sardines. Can't put your feet up on an empty stomach, can you?
You see, she thinks it's great. She's even making us sardines.
Yes, well.
I think she's terrific.
Terrific.
So, which way?
All right, before she comes back with the sardines.
Up here.
Yes, yes.
In here.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's another bathroom.
No, no, no.
Always trying to get me into bathrooms.
In here, in here.
Ooh, black sheets.
Oh, it's the linen closet. Dang it, I missed. This one, this one.
Oh, you're in a real state. You can't even get the door open.
No, it's Miss Clackett's afternoon off. Remember, we've got the place entirely to ourselves. Home, sweet home.
Dear old house.
Just waiting for us to come back.
Sneaking in like this on our wedding anniversary.
There's something we said about being a tax exile.
Leave those.
Shh.
What?
Inland Revenue may hear us. Miss Clackett!
Oh! You gave me a turn! My eye turned right out of my boots!
So did mine!
We thought you'd gone!
I thought she was in Spain!
We are! We are!
You haven't seen us!
We're not here!
Who is like that, is it? You want your things, look!
Oh, yes. Thanks.
Oh, and that bad hasn't been had, love.
Hot water bottle.
Oh, and I've put all your letters in the study, dear.
Letters? What letters? Oh, good heavens, where are they?
I put them all in the pigeon house.
In that pigeon house?
In the little pigeon house in your desk, love.
Yes, but I can hear voices.
Voices? What sort of voices?
People's voices.
But there's no one here.
Darling, I saw the door handle move.
Oh, look, she's opened our sardines.
Come back.
What?
You can't go downstairs like that.
Well, why not?
Mrs. Crackett.
Mrs. Crackett?
One has certain obligations.
Ding! You're still poking around, are you?
Yes, still poking. Well, still around.
In the linen
linen closet, were you?
Yes, I was just checking the inventory. Mrs. Blackett.
Clackett, dear, Clackett.
Yes, Mrs. Clackett. Is there anyone else in the house, Mrs. Clackett?
I haven't seen no one, dear.
I thought I heard voices.
Voices? There's no voices here, love.
I must have imagined it.
Yes. Oh, good Lord above!
I beg your pardon?
Oh, good Lord above! There's no good Lord! Oh, good Lord! The study door is open!
There's another car outside! That's not Mr. Hackham's, is it? Or Mr. Dudley's?
Tapping doors in this house.
Steps will be taken. Distraint. Proceedings in court.
Yes, and that reminds me, a gentleman came about the house.
Don't tell me I'm not here.
All right then, love. I'll just sit down and turn off the... sardines! I've forgotten the sardines. I don't know if it wasn't fixed to my show. Does I forget what day it was?
I didn't get this. I'm not here. I'm in Spain. But if I didn't get it, I didn't open it.
Darling, I never had a... rather a bunch of flowers like
this, didn't I? Didn't you?
No, I never thought. As tarty as this.
I should never have touched this.
No, it's lovely.
Stick it down, put it back. Never saw it.
Well, I'll just put it in the attic with all the other lovely things you gave me.
Here. All right. All right. Now the study doors open again. What's going on? Knocking! 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 Yes, knocking! Knocking upstairs! Yes, upstairs, knocking, yes! Oh my God! There's something in the linen closet, oh! Oh, it's you! I mean, is it you? I mean, you know, hiding under all these black sheets and things. I mean, I can't just stand here, you know. Indefinitely.
Oh, Marcy, you've been in here with all these things.
But darling, why did you lock the door?
Why did I lock the door?
I didn't lock the door.
Well,
we can't just stand here like this.
Like what?
In your nightgown.
Okay, I'll take it off.
Yes, in here, in here.
Darling, this glue, is it the sort you can never get unstuck? Oh, look, Miss Clack has made us some sardines.
A hot water bottle. I didn't put it there. I didn't put this hot water bottle. Well, I'm standing here with this hot water bottle in my hands.
Well, of course it's me. You come in here in the dark with all the black sheets and things.
Someone in the bathroom filling hot water bottles.
Well, why did I lock the door? Why did you lock the door?
Don't panic. Just don't panic. Don't panic. Don't.
It's right there.
Don't panic, don't panic. There's some perfectly rational explanation for all of this. I'll fetch Mrs. Blodgett and she'll tell us what's happening. You wait here. No, you can't stand here like that. You wait in the study. Study, study, study.
Ah! Roger, there's a strange figure in there. Where are you? Ah!
Darling, I know this is gonna sound silly, but... Darling, I can't come to bed. I'm glued to a tax demand.
Darling, why didn't you try putting the sardines down?
Darling, I'm stuck to the sardines.
Oh, darling, don't play a fool. Get the bottle-wrapped poison in the downstairs loo. That eats through anything.
I've heard of people getting stuck with a problem, but this is ridiculous. But this is ridiculous!
No bars, no burglar alarms. They ought to be prosecuted for incitement. No, but sometimes it makes me want to sit down and weep. When I think I used to do banks. When I remember, I used to do bullion vaults. What am I doing now? I'm breaking into paper bags. So, what have we got here? One microwave oven. What? 50 quid? Hardly worth lifting it. Junk, junk. If you insist. Now, where's the desk? No, they all say the same thing. They all say the same thing. Yes? Line? It's hard to what? It's hard to assess a requirement.
And the professor tenant naturally wishes to know if there...
Yes, dear, it's all nothing paranormal!
Is any history of paranormal phenomena?
Yes, sir!
I mean, has anything ever dematerialized before? Has anything ever flown about?
Flown about? No. Things just move themselves on their own 2 feet.
I'd better warn the prospective tenant she's inspecting the study. Oh my God, there's a man in there.
No, there's no one in the house, love.
No, look, he's actually searching for... Well,
I can't see something.
You can't see him, but this is a success. Oh my God.
Now what?
There.
Where?
The sardines.
Oh, the sardines.
You can see the sardines.
Yes, I can see the sardines.
I'm not letting these sardines slip out of my hand anytime soon.
Oh, I'm gonna be opening sardines all night in and out here like a cuckoo on a clock.
Vicky!
No, but I'm Mr. Violence. I miss having other humans around to terrify.
Where has she gone? Oh, Vicky!
No, but I miss the shouting and screaming. All this silence gets you down.
Vicky! Oh, Vicky!
I'm gonna end up talking to myself.
Darling! This stuff that goes on and needs to do anything?
I need a drink.
It eats through trousers. Darling, you don't think that if it goes on and eats through trousers, it eats through... Listen, darling, I think you better help me get these pants off. Darling! Help! This is an emergency! I think I can feel it! It's eating through absolutely everything!
There's something wrong! There's something evil in this house!
The Inland Revenue.
He's our back.
I'm not here.
He's not there.
I must go.
Stay.
I won't, thank you.
Speak.
Only in the presence of my lawyer.
Only in the presence of your...
Are you all right?
This is plainly a matter for the police.
Well, is there nothing more I can offer you?
No, please.
I think I'll just be running along.
Sir, come back. Please, sir. 991. Oh, hello. The police. Someone has broken into my house, or rather, someone has broken into someone's house. You know, but he's a sex maniac. There was a young woman here, and well, what's happened to her, no one knows. What's happened to her? No one knows. No one knows.
There's a man lurking in the underground!
Oh, the young woman has reappeared. Are you all right?
No, he almost saw me!
He almost saw her. No, but he's a burglar as well. He's taken our things.
Oh, but the things are here!
The things have come back, so we're just missing a plate of sardines.
Well, here are the sardines!
And we found the sardines. So what am I saying? I'm saying let's say no more about it. I thought something terrible had happened to you.
It has. I know him.
You know him?
He's been dealt with by our office.
Hey, well, then bring the sardines. I said bring the sardines.
Right. That's downstairs tidied up a bit. I'll just give the upstairs a quick going over for them.
A bath mat.
Better than nothing.
I can't go around in front of taxpayers wearing a bath mat.
Well, then put something on.
Well, I haven't got anything.
There must be something in the bedroom.
No, not going in there.
Fine. I'll look in the bedroom. You just look in the other bathroom.
Darling, help! Where are you?
Run!
think you dropped your dress. Where have you been? Look at the state I'm in. Darling! Honestly, she just burst into the room and her dress fell off.
Put this sheet on for the moment while I see if there's something in the attic.
One pair of silver taps. Oh my god.
Who are you?
Who am I? Fixing the taps.
Tax. Income tax.
That's right, Governor. Income new taps. Outgo tax.
Tax inspectors everywhere.
Here you are.
The other one.
Found your dress. Came flying out of the attic at me.
Darling, I've got her dress stuck to my head now.
Another intruder.
Just doing the taps, Governor.
A tax. Not a tax on women.
Trying to think, Governor, but I'll do the taps on the bath first.
Sex maniacs everywhere!
My god, people everywhere. I'm off. I don't know, attacks on women. I don't know, they put attacks on anything these days.
If I can't find her, you're going to be in trouble, you see.
WC, I'll fix it.
Where's she? Gone! Vicky!
Poppy!
Fine. No Sheik yet. Thought for sure he'd be here by four. Well, it's almost four now. Actually, it's almost six. Well, perhaps the Sheik is just a little tied up at the moment. Oh, Sheik. Wasn't expecting you till seven. Well, since you're upstairs already... Or perhaps we should start downstairs. Don't worry about her. She has no connection with the house, I assure you. Whereas this good lady, on the other hand...
No other hands, thank you. Not in my sardines, because this time I'm eating them.
...is fully occupied with her sardines. So perhaps the bathroom facilities would be of more interest. In here... In here we have...
Bullcocks, Governor. Your bullcocks are gone.
We have him. In the study, however...
Oh, you thieving devils! You give me that sheet! Oh, dear.
Oh, it's you!
It's her!
It's my little girl.
Dad?
It's our little Vicky who ran away from home. I never thought I'd see you again.
Where's my other sheet?
Stop! Oh, heavenly peace! I rent it!
Hold on. Hold on, I know this face. He's no Sheik. He's just that sex maniac.
What?
And what you're up to with my little girl down there in Bassett Circle, I won't ask. But I'll tell you one thing, Vicky.
What's that, Dad?
When all around is strife and uncertainty, there's nothing like a good old-fashioned...
Lloyd, I'm pregnant!
There's nothing like a good old-fashioned plate of eggplant.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Old Fish Market Theatre, Lowestoft, or rather the Municipal Theatre, Stockton-on-Tees, for this evening's performance of Nothing On. We apologize for the slight delay in starting our performance this evening, which is due to circumstances.
Hands off, Freddy, you hear? You're the one who's trying to get the hands on Freddy!
Due to circumstances.
You don't own him, you know!
That are beyond our control. And we appreciate it as you bear with us as we deal with her. Oh, with them. With the circumstances. Our long and highly successful tour is on its very last legs. And
we apologize for the slight delay in starting tonight, which is due to circumstances.
Don't you dare, don't you dare!
Which have now been brought under our control.
Our long and highly successful tour is on its very last legs. Its very last leg. Thank you
for your cooperation and understanding.
I sincerely trust that there will be no other hiccups, no other holdups. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the remainder of your evening.
Sardines up off the floor and answer the phone! I've only got one leg. No, nothing, okay. Oh, dear. Yes, well, hello. What? Now, okay. Yes, but there's no one here, love. No, Mr. Brent's not... Mr. Brent's not here. He lives here, yeah, but he don't live here now because he lives in Spain. Mr. Philip Brent, that's right, yeah. The one who writes the plays, that's him. Why he got into plays, God only knows. He'd be safer off in the lion's cage at the zoo. No, she's in Spain too. They're all in Spain. There's no one here. Am I in Spain? No, darling, I'm not in Spain. I'm in agony. Yes, no, I am. I look after the house for them, but I go home at 1 o'clock on Wednesday and I've got a nice plate of sardines. I got a nice plate of sardines. I had a nice plate of sardines. I lost them to put my feet up with because it's the right. I found them. Because it's the royal, what's it called on the telly? And if it's to do with letting the house, then you'll have to ring the house agents because they're the agents for the house. Squire, Ackerman. Hold on. who's the other one? No, they're not in Spain, dear. They're just a bit squashed is all. Squire, Ackerman, hold on. Hold on, wait. I'm going to do something wrong here. Always the same, isn't it? One minute you got too much on your plate, and then the next thing you know, they've gone again. Oh, no. Okay, there we go. Right. Thank you. Oh, dear.
I have a housekeeper, yes, but this is her afternoon off, so we've got the place entirely to ourselves. I'll just check. Hello? Is anyone at home? Hello? No, there's no one here. So what do you think?
Great, and this is all yours?
Oh, yes, it's just a little shack in the woods, really. A converted posset mill, 16th century.
It must have cost a bomb.
Yes, of course. Oh. Well, one has to have somewhere to entertain one's business associates.
Right, and I've got to get those files under Basingstoke by 4.
There's someone on the phone now by the looks of it. It must be that Arab saying he wants to come by at a... Yes. Well, we'll only just manage to fit it in. I mean, we'll only just pick it up.
Right then.
Were you looking for something?
Oh, these doors.
Yes, only a handful, really. There's a kitchen, there's a study, and there's a self-contained service lat or the receiver.
And which one's the...
What?
Oh, you know.
The usual offices through here.
Fantastic.
Ah! There's nobody here. Ah, yes. Ah! I'm sorry. I thought there was no one here.
I'm not here. I don't know where I am, actually.
I'm... From the agents.
I've lost the phone now.
Squire Hackham and Dudley.
I've never lost the phone before.
Yes, well, I'm Tramplemane.
It was here, and then it's...
No, I just dropped here. In to go into
but, okay, no, listen, shh.
Well,
I'm
to
put
do
it
one
up.
Or two odd jobs.
I am going to put it up here, and that's where it's going to be, all right?
No.
But
a prospective tenant, I'm showing a tenant perspective through the house.
What's wrong with this door?
She's thinking of renting it. Her interest is definitely aroused.
That's not the bedroom.
The bedroom? No, that's the downstairs bathroom in WC suite. And this lovely lady is the housekeeper.
Sardines! It's Sardines!
Oh, hi.
She's not really here.
Oh, you shouldn't have stood on him. You see?
We'll just inspect the house.
I will all go standing on him now.
Don't worry about us.
I'd better give the floor a wash. Got it.
Sorry about this.
That's all right. We don't want the television, do we?
Television, right. She didn't explain about wanting to watch this, you know, with the hearts and, well, because, you see, clearly this whole thing with the... Well, I mean, in case anyone's watching this and thinking, my God!
Right, and I've got to be in Basingstoke by 4.
Sorry, love, I thought we just ought to get that out of the way.
We'll take it up with us.
Where are we?
And don't let my files out of sight.
No, we've gotten out of place.
What?
What?
Huh?
Her. That's right, because she's been in the family for generations.
Sardines! It's not for me to say, of course, dear. Only I will just say this. Don't think twice about it. Take the plunge. You really enjoy it here.
Oh, great.
All right, listen, okay? I'm gonna put it up here, and then if he wants it, he won't know where to find it. Yes. Sardines! You're going to have to do the sardines now, because I've got to go to the kitchen and make some more sardines.
Oh,
I'm so excited.
Boy.
Oh, dear.
You see, she thinks it's great. She's even making us sardines.
Well?
I think she's terrific.
Terrific.
So, which way?
All right. Well, perhaps if we just sort of take the sardines and sort of parcel them
up.
No, down here.
In here.
No, down. No, you take the bag and the box.
It's another bathroom.
Bag, box.
Always trying to get me into bathrooms.
No, you do the, well, I'll do the, well,
Ooh, black sheets.
Take the, well, just take the, you do the, I'll do the, oh.
Oh, you're in a real state. You can't even get the door open.
Back its afternoon off, remember?
We've got the place entirely to ourselves.
Home.
Home, sweet home.
How old it was to find a telephone in the garden.
I'll put it back.
Yes, I thought I'd better bring it in. Someone's bound to want it.
Very sensible.
Why don't you try putting it back on the table?
Oh, yes. Oh, dear.
Yes. The just go ahead.
Wire seems to be caught on something.
Oh, yes, look. It's caught around the downstairs bathroom.
So it is?
Yes.
Darling, do you need any help over there?
Oh, no, I think I've got it on this side.
Oh, dear. Oh, my God. I think I've got it, darling.
Oh, yes, I'm sure you do over there.
Do you need any help?
You know what? I think I've untangled it.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Very sensible because of...
It's rather odd, those sneaking in like this on our wedding anniversary.
Yes, because if Inland Revenue finds out when...
Country even for one night?
Yes, sorry. Sorry, because if Inland Revenue finds out when... Wow!
Country!
Country!
Even for one
even
night?
Even for one night!
Bang!
Bang! Oh.
Goes our claim to be resident abroad.
Yes, resident abroad, absolutely.
And bang goes most of next year's income.
Most of next year's income, so I think I better go have a little lie down.
A lie down? Oh, yes, yes, well, why not? No children, no friends dropping in. We're absolutely on our leave, though. Downstairs, not upstairs.
Oh, yes, yes, I'm so sorry.
There's something to be said about being a tax exile.
Shh! What? Inland Revenue may hear us!
What I did with that first lot of sardines, I should never know.
Miss Newspaper!
You gave me a turn! My aunt jumped right out of the sofa!
Oh, so did mine. We thought you'd gone.
I thought you was in Sardinia, dear!
We are!
You haven't seen us.
We're not here.
I can bet which one of them put this here.
Right, well, the important thing is that the income tax are after us.
A lovely helping of sardines to sit on!
Right, so if you see anybody, you don't know nothing, anything. So I'll just, I'll get a hot water bottle.
Oh, wait, no, and off she goes without waiting to hear about his letter.
His letter?
Yes, his letter.
Letters? What letters? You fold on my mail, don't you?
Not a present from Sardinia, dear. I don't, no.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
You know what? I will show you where I put the presents for Sardinia, dear. I'll put them all in the pigeon house.
Oh, in the pigeon house.
Yes, darling, in the pigeon house. Down here.
Oh.
Yes, enjoy those.
I'm going to...
Yes, but I can hear... Oh. Here, boxes.
Voices? What sorts of voices?
Box voices, I mean.
But there's no one here.
People's boxes. Yes, but whoever put these here, well, they could still be around.
Well, I still don't see why you put your tie on to go look.
Well, it could be Mrs. Crockett, you know, well, carrying things up and down the stairs.
Oh, look, she's opened our sardines!
Oh, no, come back.
What?
You can't go downstairs like that.
Why not?
Well, Mrs. Crockett.
Mrs. Crockett.
One has certain obligations.
Sardines here, sardines there. It's like the Battle of Waterloo out here. Oh, you're still poking around, are you?
Yes, I'm still poking. Well, still... pulling.
In the linen closet, were you?
Yes, well, I was just inspecting all of the doors, making sure all the handles...
Right.
Well, were in working order. Mrs. Blackett.
Clackett.
Yes, Mrs. Clackett. Is there anyone else in the house, Mrs. Clackett?
No, I haven't seen no one, dear, no.
I thought I heard voices.
Voices? There's no voices here, love.
I must have imagined it then.
Yes.
Oh, God! Lord! Above!
I beg your pardon. Why, what is it?
It's dirty doors, isn't it?
Yes, of course. Well, they're going to want these inside. Oh my God, they're going to want them outside.
Yes, they might, yeah.
Nothing but flapping doors in this handle.
Final notice, steps will be taken to strain proceedings in court.
Oh, good Lord, who are you?
I'm Philip.
You're Philip? And what happened to him?
It's all a bit slippery on the stairs out there.
Yeah. You haven't done himself an injury, have you?
No, just a bit shaken up. God. He'll be all right.
Dear God.
You weren't going to tell me a man had come about the house, were you?
What?
You weren't going to tell me a man had come about the house, were you?
Yes, okay, right. So, a gentleman has come about the house.
Don't tell me I'm not here.
He said he got your box out in the garden for you.
Let him do whatever he wants, just as long as he doesn't know I'm here.
All right, then, love. So I'll just sit down and turn on the sardines. I've forgotten the sardines. I haven't forgotten the sardines. I remember the sardines. I'm going to go to the kitchen and make some more sardines to celebrate. Yeah.
I'm not here. I'm in Spain. And I'm not here. I didn't get it. And if I didn't get it, I didn't open it.
Darling. Darling? Darling, I never had... a handle like this, did I?
Didn't you?
No, I'd never buy anything as brassy as this.
Well, I never should have touched it.
Right, well, it's lovely.
Set it down, put it back. Never saw it.
I'll just put it in the attic if anyone else wants to have a try.
All right. Now the study doors. Oh, my God. Open again! Oh my God, what's knocking? Yes, knocking, yes. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God! Darling, well, No. Darling, you see, I can't exactly, I can't open the door right now. Well, because you see, just stop knocking! Please. Well, okay. I'll come over here. Maybe if you just... climb over the... squeeze through the... well, maybe if you just shimmy down the... for pity's sake!
Final notice. Steps will be taken.
Oh, it's you!
Yes, it's me. You put me here in the dark with all the black sheets and things!
Yes, I did put you in there, but somehow... do you know what I mean?
Why did I lock the door? Why did you lock the door?
Well, I couldn't, because, you know.
Someone locks the door!
Sorry!
Well, we can't just stand here like this.
Like what?
You know, with people running in and out.
Okay, I'll take it off.
Oh, yes, do that in here.
Final notice. Steps will be taken. Distraint proceedings in court.
A first aid bottle box.
I didn't put it there.
I didn't put it there.
Someone in the bathroom filling first aid boxes Sorry. With flaming hot Cheetos.
You don't think there's something creepy going on, do you? Darling, are you coming to bed or aren't you?
What? What did you say?
I didn't say anything.
First the door handles and now this first water box.
I can feel goose pimples all over.
Yes, quick, let's get something around around you.
Quick, get the covers over our heads.
Yes, well, maybe, oh my God, what did I do with those sardines? Oh, you wait here.
You hear all sorts of funny things about these old houses.
Yes, of course, but this one has been extensively modernized. I don't think anything creepy would survive oil. Oh my God.
What? What is it? What's happening?
The sardines, they've gone. No, they haven't, they're here. Well, you see, you put a plate of sardines down only for 2 minutes, and you know what? The last thing you expect to find when you come back, well, you see, you go out, you come back, and you look down, and what the last thing you expect to see is, well, a plate of, I mean, that's really weird.
Well, perhaps there is something creepy going on. I'm going to get in bed and put my head under the...
Well, because there they are. No, they're not.
Bag!
Well, yes, perhaps Mrs. Sprotchett must have, well, she could have, you know, bag, what bag?
Bag!
What bag?
Bag, bag!
Bag. Sardines.
Bag.
Sardines, sardines.
Bag, bag, bag.
Sardines, 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 sardines. Bag,
bag
what
bag? Bag, 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 bag. No bag.
No bag.
Your bag, suddenly here, now gone.
Well, it's in the bedroom. At least I put it in the bedroom. I'll put it back in the bedroom.
No, don't go in there.
The box.
The box?
They've both not gone.
Oh, my files!
Oh, what on earth's happening? Where's Mrs. Sprotchett? You just wait in the bedroom.
No, no, no.
Oh, please, at least put your dress
I'm
on.
I'm not going in there.
I'll fetch it for you. I'll fetch it for you.
Yes, quick, let's get out of here.
Yes, well, your dress is gone.
I'm never going to see Bussing Stoke again.
Yes, just don't panic. Don't panic. There's some perfectly rational.
Final notice. Steps will be taken. Oh, dear!
Darling, are you... Oh, great heavens! Thank you, not in my sardines. This is so... She's gone and killed him!
Oh, no, keep going. He's just stunned. He's fine. Keep going.
Don't panic. Don't panic. There's some perfectly rational...
Where are we?
Explanation for all
of
this.
Oh, my God. Keep going.
I'll fetch Mrs. Sprotchett and she'll tell us what's happening.
You fetched her, darling. I'm here.
Oh, yes, I fetched Mrs. Sprotchett now. She'll tell us what's happening.
She won't, you know.
I'll tell you what's happening.
There's a man in there, yes?
No. Look, he's here, and so am I.
No, no, no. Oh. There's no one in the house, love you.
No. God. Listen, I know this must come as a surprise for all of us. Finding a man lying at the bottom of the stairs, it sure was a shock for us. Yes, but now that we've all met one another, now we all just have to introduce ourselves. Yes.
Introduce ourselves. Yes.
I'm Trent Blaine.
Yes. Yes.
Oh dear.
This man here, he is my husband, and I'm afraid surprises go straight to his nose.
There's a man lurking in the undergrowth.
How exciting! Another guest. Why don't you go look and see what you can find in the garden, and darling? Why don't you get that bottle of poison in the downstairs loo that eats through anything else?
Yes, because I've heard of people getting stuck with a problem! But this is ridiculous.
No bars, no burglar alarms. They ought to be prosecuted for incitement.
A burglar, this is most exciting.
Oh, yes, come in and join the party, love, is it?
Oh, dear. I believe this is all my fault, you see, because I'm supposed to say I've heard of people getting stuck with a problem, but it's ridiculous, and then I open the door.
No bars, no burglar alarms. They ought to be prosecuted for insult.
Keep going.
Yes, but sometimes it makes me want to weep.
Yes, it is getting like a funeral in here, isn't it, love?
I think I used to do banks. When I remember, I used to do bullion bulls.
Right, keep going now.
Stop.
No.
You see, I thought the coast was clear, so I'm going out to the bathroom.
Oh, yes, we'll figure that out later, Selsdon. Just keep going, Selsdon.
No,
yes, just keep going.
I heard him very clearly. What's that line he says?
I've heard of people getting stuck with a problem, but this is ridiculous.
Yeah, and you open the door like this.
No bars, no burglar alarms. That's to be prosecuted for incitement.
They always come in trees, don't they?
When I think I used to do banks. When I remember, I used to do bullion bulls.
Wait a second. We know this man. He is no burglar. He is our social worker.
What?
He's our social worker, the man that comes in and tells us what to do.
What to do.
What's he saying?
He's saying do it for the doors and sardines.
Okay. Doors and sardines.
He's saying phones and police.
Ow, here's a phone. Police? Yes, hello? Someone has broken into my house, or rather.
No. Someone's... He's saying bags and boxes.
Bags and boxes.
And he's saying sheets.
Sheets.
And now he's saying, all we want now is a happy ending.
Yes, and yes, and here she is, and her wedding
dress. It's
her
wedding
dress. Guys, it's their wedding day. Okay, do you take this chic to be your lovely wedded wife? If not, speak now. I've ever heard your pace.
Yes.
Yay! What's he saying now?
He's saying last line.
Last line.
When all around is strife and uncertainty, there's nothing like a good old-fashioned plate of...
Other way! Come on!
The lights off!
Sawdust and the horses and the smell, the towel you've taken from the last hotel.
There's no business like show, business like no, business like no.
You get word before the show has started that your favorite uncle died at dawn. Your ma and pa have parted, you're brokenhearted, but you go on.
There's no...
They're out of style for Broadway. Always wears a smile. A million lights, they flicker there. A million hearts beat quicker.